Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another question in this video. So we have this table called employee. We have the columns ID, name, joining date. So you need to apply some logic on the ID column and derive the new ID. If you see the values, these are 1, 7, 4, 13, 10 and 16. So there is some logic behind this. You need to understand what is the logic. And you have to write an SQL query such that this new ID is populated based on the logic. So now let's see what is the logic. Let's understand what is the logic. So first step is you need to calculate the column, new column with the formula 3 into ID minus 2. And the second step is if the total number of rows in the table are even, you need to swap the values with the next row, excluding both the first row and last row. So if you are having 6 rows, you need to swap row number 2, row number 3 and row number 4 and row number 5. So row number 1 and row number 6 needs to be in the same way as it is in step 1. And if the total number of rows are odd, you need to swap the values with the next row. So in this case, you need to exclude the first row only. Okay. So if the row count is 5, exclude the first row. Row number 2 and row number 3 should be swapped. Row number 4 and row number 5 should be swapped. So let's understand this example. So step 1, so new ID you are creating based on the 3 into ID minus 2. So here 3 into 1 minus 2. So 3 into 1 is 3, 3 minus 2 is 1. So here it is 1. 3 into 2 minus 2. 3 into 2 is 6, 6 minus 2 is 4. This is 4. 3 into 3, 9 minus 2 is 7. Like that you are calculating for all the 6 rows. And step 2, the swapping logic needs to be applied. So since the total number of row count is even here, so you need to exclude the first row and the sixth row. So row number 2 should be swapped with row number 3. So here ID 2's value is 4 and ID 3 value is 7. So 4 and 7 should become 7 and 4. And here 10 and 13 should become 13 and 10. And the first row and the last row 1 and 16 should be the same. So hope you have understood the question. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio and see how to solve this using SQL. So I have inserted this data. So if you want to practice this, you can find this script in the description of this video. So this is the data. So first, let's apply this step 1, create a new column with 3 into ID minus 2. So it is simple. So select star from employees, okay, and here the column is new ID, new underscore ID. So what is the new ID formula? It is 3 into ID minus 2 as new ID, correct? So this is the formula, and if you run this query, you get the new ID values 1, 4, 7, 10, 13 and 16. So now what you need to do, you have to apply the swapping logic. So the step 1 is very easy. You can just apply the formula as a calculator column, you'll get it. The difficulty lies in understanding how to apply the swapping logic. Okay. So first what I will do, I'll create a CTE. I'll keep this in a CTE. So with CTE as and select from CTE A left join CTE B. Okay. Okay, now I'll write the star. So let's do this cross left join on 1 is equal to 1. So basically this is the cross join. So now let's see what is happening when we apply this cross join. Okay, so if you see, same row is getting joined with all the rows, right? So now what we need to do is ignore the first row and the last row, and row number 2 and ID 2 and 3 should be swapped, right? So 1 should be ignored the same way. So now ID 2, this should be mapped to ID 3. Okay, this row, in this particular 5-6 rows, only this row should be filtered out. Okay, 2 should be mapped with 3. And for ID 3, only this particular row should be filtered out. 3 should be mapped to 2. Okay, so how will 2 and 3 join, and how will 3 and 2 join? So how will we join? So A dot ID is equal to case when A dot ID mod 2 is equal to 0, then B dot ID plus 1, okay, and when a dot id mod 2 is equal to 1, then b dot id minus 1. So here what we are trying to do, so whenever if the a dot id is an even number, a dot id mod 2 is 0, that means that is an even number. So 2 is an even number, so I am joining b dot id plus 1. So b dot id plus 1 is 1. Oh, okay, I had to do this b dot id minus 1, and here it is plus 1. So b dot id minus 1, so 3 minus 1 is 2. So that's, in that case 2 and 3 will be joined. Okay, so a dot id mod 2 is 2, so I mean is equal to 0, so id 2 should be joined with 3, right? So 3 is nothing but how will you get 2 from 3? 3 minus 1 is 2, so b dot id minus 1. And for id 3 you have to get 2, right? So 2 plus 1 is 3, so b dot id plus 1. Okay, so now in this way, if you write this logic, what is happening? Let's see. Okay, if you write this logic, the first row for id 1, you are getting a null new id, and for all other rows, so if you see, id 2 is joined to id 3, id 3 is joined to id 2, id 4 is joined to 5, 5 is joined to 4, and 6 is joined to null. Okay, so now what I will do here, a dot id comma a dot name comma a dot joining date comma is null, I will use is null of b dot new underscore id comma a dot new underscore id as new underscore id. So what I am trying to do here, if first I am taking this joins data, so this b second half of the data, because we need to swap the value. So 4 should be swapped with 7 and 7 should be swapped with 4. So that's why we need to take this particular column value as new id. Okay, if you see, this is swapped rows. Okay, 4 is swapped with 7 here and 7 is swapped with 4. So this row we have to take, suppose, and for the first and last rows the new id is null. So in that case, if it is null, if the b dot new id is null, then you have to take the a dot new id, because swapping will not apply to this first and last rows. So that's why I have used the is null condition. Okay, so now if you run this query, you are getting this same data which we have seen earlier. Okay, so second and third ids data is swapped, fourth and fifth ids data is swapped. Okay, so now let's take the other condition also. See, here the row count is even, so here this is working. So now let's remove the sixth row and see if it is working. The same condition is working. Okay, I am executing this. Now 5 rows are there. So now let's see if I'll keep the a dot joining, a dot new id as well, so that we'll understand whether the swapping is happening properly or not. Okay, now if you see here, okay, so if you see here, a dot new id is nothing but the CTE's data. So CTE new id, whatever is calculated based on the step 1, 3x minus 2, that is a dot new id. So this new id's data is this a dot new id. Okay, so initially you are getting 1, 4, 7, 10 and 13. Okay, so now you have, in this case the row count is 5, so you are ignoring the first row. So id 2 and 3 should be swapped, so 4 and 7 have become 7 and 4, and 4 and 5 should be swapped, 10, 13 became as 13 and 10. Okay, so in this way, in this case, only first row is getting ignored and second row is getting, all other rows are getting swapped. So in this way you need to write the condition. So basically here the main part is you need to understand that you have to use the self join, and also you need to understand this join condition. So if you understand this join condition easily, you will be able to crack this. So one tip here while solving these kind of conditions, so always try to create a cross join first. Okay, so always try to create a cross join and then try to see, understand what is the logic to filter out the required rows. So if you are practicing in this route, then you will get this idea of this, then you will get that idea on how to write this condition. So that is the way you need to write this answers or the create these solutions. So hope you all like this question. So if you like, please click on the like button. And if you are watching our videos for the first time, make sure you click on subscribe button so that you'll get new videos every once in 2-3 days. Thank you. Have a nice day.